bit in my Christian country home. I learned to play the flat top on them good old gospel songs. Then I heard about the bar rooms just across the Georgia line, where a boy can make a living playing guitar late at night. I had to learn about the ladies, 'cause I was too young to understand why the young girls fall in love with the boys in the band. When the boys turn to music, the girls just turn away to some other guitar picker in some other late night place. Yeah, I held on to my music, I let the ladies walk away. I took my songs and dreams to Nashville and moved on to L.A. Up to New York City, all across the USA. Well, I lost so much of me, but there's enough of me.
Good morning, Discovery. We know all the folks back in Alabama, particularly Auburn, are real proud of their alumna who's up there today.
Thanks, Bill. I sure appreciate the music, and hopefully we'll fly over Alabama during the flight and get some good pictures.
Good morning to you, Dr. Davis. How are things today?
Good morning. Things are going well on Discovery, and it's a beautiful day outside on orbit.
Let's talk about the current mission right now. You're studying what's happening to the Earth's ozone layer.
That's correct. On flight day one, we deployed the CRISPR-5 satellite, and it's out there scanning the Earth's atmosphere from north to south and through several altitudes, and we're looking at different chemicals in the different altitudes around the world to see where the ozone is and how much of it is there, as well as other chemicals.
Crew members yesterday tested out a new robotic arm. You're actually nearby the workstation where that robotic arm is controlled. It gave you a little bit of trouble. Where do we stand with that?
I think we understand the complexities of what we did on flight day two. This is the workstation where we operated the robotic arm, which is a Japanese robotic arm, which will be part of the Japanese arm on the space station. These are the two hand controllers. We have a computer here which also controls the arm, as well as some switches. The problems we had on flight day two were, we think, just the force torque sensor, which tries to take out the forces and torques that we're applying to the arm, may have been overreacting a little bit. So we're going to just turn that on at the very last minute when we grapple the box that we're trying to take out of its bracket. And we think it'll work just fine today. We're going to give it another try. And it was flying just beautifully. The only problem we had was with that force torque sensor compliance.
Now, this is your third mission in space. Has the newness worn off at all? I mean, are you able just to go to work every day and think about what you're doing, or are you still a little bit amazed at what you get to do for a living?
I'm amazed every day at what I get to do for a living, but the first day on orbit, I felt like I was right at home. This is a great working environment, and I just love being up here. Of course, the Earth is the Earth's atmosphere and the Earth's weather and everything is constantly changing, so every day is different as far as what we can see on the ground, and that's just always fascinating. It's just beautiful to watch the Earth go by, and I wish we had more time to do that, but it's really beautiful. We saw the storm Winnie in the western Pacific starting to form this morning. It's a huge storm, and it was just awesome to view it from orbit.
I want to just get to a personal level briefly. Your husband is also an astronaut. Have either of you been up on the same shuttle mission ever, and have you had a chance to talk with him back on Earth?
Well, as a matter of fact, we did fly together back in 1992 on Space Lab J. We were on different shifts, but we did manage to pass each other in the airlock as we were going to work each day, and that was really a great experience to be able to share that flight together. He was last on the Hubble mission, one of the spacewalking astronauts, and so I think we're both really glad that we have somebody we can share those experiences with and enjoy watching the other person have fun in space.
I want to ask you a question about some of the other highlights of NASA this year, talking about the Pathfinder mission to Mars. It's raised a lot of awareness and a lot of excitement, really, for exploring other parts of the solar system. Do you see in the near future maybe the next generation of astronauts, maybe the generation of astronauts to come after you, setting foot on the red planet?
Well, I certainly hope so. Our country is a nation of explorers, and we're always exploring the unknown, and I certainly believe that would be the next step. And I'm really glad that we have all of this information about the other planets, and we can prepare ourselves for that trip to Mars someday. So I hope that there's some kids out there up early in the morning watching TV that they will someday aspire to be astronauts walking on Mars.
Houston Discovery. This is Bjarni here. I'm just about to set up the ice cap experiment, having completed the GORP and the bubbles run, and I completed all of those. This here little thing in my hand is the wave maker for the ice cap experiment. So we have a thin film, and we generate waves by driving this little wave maker to oscillate a little paddle inside the cell. And I better go down to do that, because we get on with it.
Thanks, Bjarni.